Macmillan Audio presents Shame is an Ocean I Swim Across. Written and performed by Mary Lambert. One. My body is terrifying. Idaho is a giant shithole, and other wholesome stories. How I Learned to Love. When I was 15, I hated everything except for Weezer. And maybe like two people, and cereal. One time a boy grabbed me in the music room and kissed my neck in front of everybody. I did not want to be kissed, but I thought I was supposed to want to be kissed. I did not know what to do, and so I laughed. I knew you were supposed to laugh after things like that. The world had taught me to dress up my trauma in short skirts and secret bathroom crying, to protect the fragility of boys at all costs. When I was 5, my father molested me. You become a strange human that way. You cannot whip yourself awake as a child. I should have been born a bird. When I turned 6, I stopped talking. When I was 25 and my name was on the radio, I asked people to write poems and send them to me. Maybe because I was starved of honest humanity, half of the poems were about slit wrists. I do not want to know any more about this brand of humanity. All I know of love is hunger. When I met you, I planted my heart into the heavy earth. I was scared, but you smiled back. Thank God I was not born a bird. Evelyn is made up. The little girl is a theater of shame and laughter. She is eating lunch in the library again. She tucks the desk into her ribs to feel smaller. The hurt is ricocheting from her mother's thighs into the girl's thighs. The mother's hips are too big, the mother says. The silver hope can of Slim Fast sits in the fridge, waits. The boys are cruel and predictable. The girl renames herself Evelyn. Evelyn does not cry at school, wears a ruby cardigan, is the star. Evelyn can run so fast. She has beautiful ribboned braids. She buys hot lunch effortlessly, not even reduced. She pays full price. Evelyn is made up. The girl knows this. Nothing is real since the incest. The girl can't breathe through her nose because of the mold. The girl breathes loudly. It is a good joke for everyone. I am hurting so much this winter. I am fucking everyone and nothing matters. I wore braids to an award show. I started wearing dark lipstick and crying in the shower. My sheets are beautiful. I kiss everyone I meet. The end of the world fits inside of my cocktail. I never fixed myself. I am my own arduous endeavor. I light myself on fire for everyone. I am the arsonist and the lover, all choked into one great sex bouquet. And Evelyn is here inside me. She is magnificent and ordering room service like a pro. My mother still makes me cry from her love and her sweet eyes and sugared compassion. The only parts I remember of my childhood are lies I told myself to feel better. Epidemic for Belltown. The girl with purple hair is sitting at my bar again. I think she is beautiful, but not in a way that I want to have awesome sex with her, but in a way that I want to drink chocolate martinis together and go shopping for Christmas vests that have tinkly bells and maybe even polar bears with hats on them. She's having a full body cry. I am the worst bartender simply because I don't know how to counsel people without crying back at them. She's crying about the state of women. I know that we come from the same rotting wood, so all I do is nod. Rape is not a man behind a bush with a knife, she laughs. It's kissing you on the mouth like whiskey at a nice bar. The girl with purple hair and I are holding hands now. I only wanted an apology, an acknowledgement of what occurred. Grappling as artists, as girls, as ships and bottles, how do we change any of it? I tell her I'm gonna write a poem. She says, no one wants to hear a rape poem, Mary. Rape poem. Have you ever seen a stampede of horses? Do you wonder what the hooves look like from underneath? Have you tasted the blood from biting your own lips because you couldn't say no loud enough? I never fought back. I didn't punch him. I kept my thighs tight and closed, but once he's inside you, you wish you were a street lamp, a seat belt, a box of nails, of rust, something hard and ruined. You'll wish you were a wild pony, a slick fish on a line, anything but a woman. Once he's inside you, you just kind of give up. And your eyes glaze over. And they stay that way for years. Tips for fat girls. You are the ugly best friend. You are the misguided, the chubby comical relief. You are the sweet girl with inner beauty, and you will always be second best. The summer I turned 9, I gained 50 pounds. It was the first time I ate an entire box of Oreo cookies. The first time my reflection was foreign from weight. The first time I cradled my stomach like a child. It was the first time I said, Mama, I hate my body. I want to slice off these parts right here. But I know better now. I know girls like me have to grow a tough skin, Always be ready for rejection. Always be prepared to be left for the thin ones. Yes, they will always leave you for the thin ones. Be funny. Laugh at yourself. You cannot afford to be quiet and sad. Learn how to drink heavily. Learn how to hide your vulnerability. Become obsessed with your art. Always turn the light off before fucking. Always lay on your stomach. Always be on a diet. Always be generous. And when they take away the most beautiful, sacred pieces of you that you have to offer, always smile. You might at least have a cute face. Learn how to give head. Be eager, be easy, be agreeable. Call the shit covering your bones something creative, something like curvy or a little extra. Stop calling them thunder thighs. It only feels like earthquakes when you walk. Tell yourself that the aching will end, that the tugging at your shirt is because of the apron of your belly. Hide it. Hide your roundness at all costs. Be molding clay, be an anchor, be dependable, be a model wearing heels, yell at the scale, call her the devil's hooves. Stop taking baths. Your body does not fit the way you want it to. The water does not cover your awful. Throw up, split yourself into two halves. Call one half your mother, tell her your diet is working. Call the other half Dove, no. Call the other half shut up and smile. Call her Persephone, call her that bitch. Don't be a bitch, don't be a fat bitch. Be nice, be a work in progress. Have an ego, be a fierce femme. Wear makeup as if you can't stand to look at your own face, because femininity is the only thing they've left you with. You cannot afford to be without bronzer, without teeth that sparkle, hoop skirts, hair that curls, hair that frames the face, get tattoos, quote Marilyn Monroe, talk about Renaissance painters. Never let them know how lonely it is to have a body that is a joke, the punchline in comedies, the before picture. Never let them know you want to be something other than the ugly best friend. Never let them know that the next person to reach their hands into your chest may look at you in awe at how surprisingly breakable you are. How you have survived this long. Why I slept with makeup on for 5 years. For Kelsey Lauk, Amanda Redwood, and Angela Tislow. When I am sleeping, I want to be a movie girl. I want my hair to be cascading around my shoulders, lips still bright and eyelashes deep. Want my monster to shine with a Sephora glow. Want you to see the pretty parts of me. Even angle my face to seem thinner in the dark. I am afraid of my exposed, naked, mostly my ugly. This is my body, and I'm terrified of the things it can and cannot do. I wonder how many women are painting themselves into movie girls while they sleep. Angling their faces, alien to themselves, an unnecessary surrender to things that kill them, to things that are not real. I tell myself in the mirror, applying the second coat of mascara, these things are not real. You can't save your family. For the chalk poems on Capitol Hill in 2010, and to anyone who read them. Melissa and I are newly 21, and drinking port in her apartment. Something about Bach playing on the balcony makes me feel older. Sitting next to her, pools of gray mascara shooting down her cheeks. We are talking about sad feelings. She cares too much about people, I think. Girls like us are barbed wire, who've learned to tease without puncturing, pretending fire doesn't burn calluses, scaling the wick with our small hands. Because no one will hear you if you never tell them that you were being fucked without permission. Fascinating how the tiny whimpers of a trespassed voice chameleons itself into a small phrase the next day. The loaded chorus of, I am okay, I am okay, I am okay, I am okay. Well, I suppose everyone is okay, depending on what your calibration of pain is. So you can remember that when he is high on heroin and you are detached.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.